Hey guys, today our topic is going to be DNA, and the goals that I have for you are I would like you to be able to match DNA bases correctly, and you're going to explain the difference between chromatids, chromosomes, and DNA. That might not sound like a lot to you right now, but you'll see what it means in just a minute. So DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid, and most of us probably know stuff about DNA just from watching movies like Jurassic Park or watching shows like CSI. But the basic thing that we need to understand is that it is the hereditary material. DNA is kind of in the structure of a double helix, which we kind of describe as like a spiral-shaped ladder. And each rung of that ladder, that means each step, is made of a phosphate and a deoxyribose sugar kind of on the side. And then the actual step itself is made of a nitrogenous base. The four different nitrogenous bases are adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Those four nitrogenous bases have matches that they go with, actually, because as you guys know, if there's not an opposite side of the ladder will fall over. So the four nitrogenous bases, adenine, thymine, cytosine, and guanine, they only match with one of the other bases. A always matches with T, and that means that T always matches with A. C always matches with G, and that means that G always matches with C. I like to line those up. The C and the G kind of have that rounded shape, so you can always match those up pretty easily. And then I just figure A and T go together. Ta-ta, at, whatever you want to say there. So this matching is key for the replication of DNA. So really, you only need one half of the DNA to make an entire brand new strand, because you can use that kind of as your template copy. So let's practice matching our different DNA strands together. So I've given you the left half of this DNA strand. You need to give me the corresponding letters on the right half. So if you didn't already get out a sheet of paper, which I should have said at the beginning, sorry guys, my bad. Just write them down on a sheet of paper. You will be doing this in a couple days. If you can just do it in your head, that's fine. So what matches with that A, that G, the T, the C, C, A, T? Okay, so match them up. In this next slide, we're going to see what the answers are. So as you guys can see on this slide, the A matches up with the T. Remember, A and T always match up. G goes with C, T goes with A, C goes with G, C goes with G again, A goes with T, and then T goes with A. Remember, the A adenine and the T thymine always match up. You can just make that word at. Okay, that's the only two letters that will make a real word, by the way. And then the G and the C have that rounded shape. That's how I remember that they always go together. So guanine and cytosine always go together. So you might be wondering, Mr. Ross, why do we need to care about matching all these bases? Well, this is the reason why. Groups of three bases together are called a codon. And we actually use those codons as a code. Get it? Codon, code. We use it as a code to build our proteins. It's a code that tells which part of the protein needs to go where. So proteins do everything for the cell. So if we put in the wrong codon or the wrong code, you get the wrong protein. And this could, in some cases, actually kill the cell. Now, this is also sometimes beneficial, but a lot of times it's not. So it's just kind of luck of the draw. So you need to know how to match these up, because later on when we talk about mitosis and meiosis together, you're going to see how everything kind of comes together, and how, you know, sometimes you have two copies of everything, sometimes you only have one copy of everything. So now that we've talked about DNA structure in the cell, we need to talk about how things kind of get on a bigger level. So DNA is uncoiled, and it's just in the strand form for most of the life of the cell. During that time when it's uncoiled, it's used to make proteins in the nucleus. And then right before cell division, especially before mitosis, the DNA has to replicate, and it's still uncoiled for that part. But during the actual dividing process in mitosis, or in meiosis, you'll find out later, the DNA has to condense. It's got to come together so it's a little bit more manageable. Otherwise, it'd be like carrying around like a humongous hose that's uncoiled. It's just not easy to do. So it coils around these proteins, and we form this kind of long DNA protein strand, which is called chromatin. Okay, so we have chromatin. It's just a long strand. So after we get that long chromatin, that chromatin actually condenses even further and it forms things called chromosomes and chromatids. When the chromatin condenses, it forms this big X-shaped thing, which you guys have seen in like mitosis and meiosis. And that's called a chromosome. The chromosome is the X-shaped thing. The chromosome actually has two halves, and those halves are called chromatids. So you guys can see on the left side there's the yellow one, right side there's the bluish one. Two chromatids. Those chromatids attach together in the kind of center part, and that's called a centromere. It's actually this protein disc that detaches the two parts together. Now, how do these all relate together? Well, each chromatid has the exact same DNA as the other chromatid. So really, when you have one chromosome, it's a double copy of everything. Now, we don't need those double copies. What ends up happening is during mitosis, or meiosis actually, one chromatid gets pulled to one side and the other chromatid gets pulled to the other side. That way, the resulting cells during mitosis have just one copy of everything, and that's really all that they need. So, if you got two copies, sometimes bad things can happen, and sometimes other good things can happen. So now that we've kind of covered some of the stuff with DNA, we haven't learned everything. We got a lot more in-depth stuff we'll find out later. I wanted to just have you guys review a little bit of stuff. Just remember, DNA has bases that code for the proteins. Those bases are adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine. I want you to memorize for tomorrow which ones match together. Okay? To do that, you could practice with this strand. Okay, so match this DNA strand to its opposite strand. AGGTTACCAG. And then the other thing that you need to get ready for tomorrow is I want you to be able to compare and contrast a chromatid with a chromosome. You guys got that stuff together, you'll be prepared a little bit better for the comparison that we're going to do between meiosis and mitosis. So, have a good night. See ya.